we are looking at the Ebola virus disease. You know, a few days ago, we were all stunned by the revelation that the disease is found its way to some neighboring countries. And indeed, some people have died in Guinea. And we were all alarmed. The government put all of us on alert, reminding us about the dangers. Because you know, Ebola has been killed. We used to hear of stories of this disease in Central African Republic, the Congo Republics. Little did we know that one day it would be so close to us. Indeed, on Sunday, we were told that one person had died as a result of the disease. And health officials assured us that should not be alarmed because they were conducting further tests. Not with the same thing we looked at one, they were conducting further tests. And thank God yesterday, the Minister of Health, Ms. Shereaite, announced at a news conference that after all, a 12-year-old girl did not die from Ebola. Every Ghanaian heaved a sigh of relief because yesterday in the morning, news was making around that because of fear that the disease would spread, they are not allowed to even shake hands any longer, not even in your home, not with friends, not at the workplace, and all that. We were all alarmed, but we must say this, that the Ministry of Health and the Ghana Health Service and other health officials have managed the situation so well. But we are on course once again trying to deal with this health emergency. You know, some time ago when the bird flu disease broke out in some parts of the continent, task force was set up to look at the situation. And we had a few cases, we were able to manage it very effectively. I did not cause the kind of havoc that we read about in other countries. So once again, we have done well. And when we have done well, we should say and commend those who have done well. But when they fail, we will talk about it. Indeed, the country representative of the World Health Organization has commended us for our efforts to manage the situation, and what is necessary going forward is to make sure that we keep our borders so tight that we do not allow the disease to come and cause any havoc here. We know that our borders are porous, people walk in and out at any time, and therefore it's difficult to say that you are not going to allow people from modern neighboring countries to visit your country. But if our port health authorities are alert, they will be able to screen people so that anybody suspected to be carrying the disease is not allowed to enter the country to spread the disease and create fear and panic and dislocate our endeavors as well as the economic activities. It is a very major health concern. It will not only be a health concern if we are not lucky and the disease brings up here too, because it has no cure and it's going to affect people. People will be alarmed. Going out will become difficult. Our economic activities will be affected. So it's more of a health. It's also a social and economic issue that we need to address in a more holistic manner so that we bring the situation under control and we do not cause a stir in a society where people would then be afraid to carry out their daily endeavors. We need the support of everybody. Ghana Health Service authorities must be supported. They must also carry out more public education on the disease, the symptoms and how to make sure that you avoid this deadly disease. So we're calling on the health authorities to intensify their public education. We don't have information, and we are not familiar with the disease, and therefore more public education will help us to sit up and be alert in order to avoid the ramification of this Ebola disease. We want everybody to participate in efforts to contain this disease. In that regard, join us on our platform, www.graphic.com.gh.